let's dive into the world of malware. So, what exactly is malware? Malware refers to any software designed to harm computers, including a wide range of malicious programs. These include viruses, worms, Trojan horses, logic bombs, backdoors, keyloggers, and zombie software. Let's start by examining viruses and worms. What exactly is a virus? A virus is a type of malware capable of self-replication. Viruses have several key features. Firstly, a virus isn't a standalone program. It requires a host program to function. This host can be an executable file or Microsoft Office applications. Office files with macros are common carriers. These are typical virus hosts. Second feature, users must open infected files to activate the virus. It won't run automatically otherwise. Third feature, viruses don't typically self-propagate. Now, let's examine worms. Worms are network-spreading malicious programs. However, worms differ from viruses in several ways. Firstly, worms can survive on their own. They don't require a host program to function. Secondly, worms self-execute and self-propagate. As a result, worms are functionally more potent than viruses. How can we protect ourselves from worms? Here are a few key precautions. First, avoid downloading from untrusted sources. Second, don't run suspicious programs. Lastly, keep your software patched and up to date. Now, let's dive into the world of Trojan horses. So, what exactly is a Trojan horse? A Trojan horse is software with hidden, malicious functions. It appears harmless on the surface, but secretly performs malicious actions. Unlike viruses, it doesn't self-replicate or spread. Instead, it lies dormant in your system, waiting to steal your personal information. And the worst part, it's hard to spot. Trojans often masquerade as legitimate software, tricking users into downloading and running them. For instance, they might name themselves RealPlay to seem legit. It's often disguised as the popular RealPlay media player. How can we protect against Trojans? We should use antivirus software to detect, isolate, and remove them. Now, let's discuss logic bombs. A logic bomb is code deliberately inserted by developers into a program to perform malicious actions. It's triggered when specific conditions are met, executing its harmful payload. How can we prevent logic bombs? First, tighten oversight of development teams. Implement robust, security-focused development practices. We must safeguard against employees embedding logic bombs in software. Project managers should then assemble a specialized team to audit the source code. Lastly, legal authorities should establish specific legislation to penalize those who plant logic bombs. Now, let's explore the concept of backdoors. What exactly is a backdoor program? It's a hidden access point in software, bypassing normal entry methods. These backdoors allow developers to circumvent standard authentication protocols, facilitating easier code modification and debugging. From this definition, we can conclude that initially, backdoors were tools created by developers to simplify code modification and debugging. So how do we defend against this? We need to bring in a specialized team, an independent third party to audit the source code. Now, let's discuss spyware. What is spyware? It's malware targeting web browsers, typically used to track browsing habits and bombard users with unwanted ads. It falls into several categories. First category, web browsing surveillance. Tracks user browsing patterns. Reports data to servers or hackers. Reveals online shopping behavior. Second category, browser hijacking. Alters browser settings. Changes default homepage. Redirects to hacker's website. Third category, password theft. Uses keyloggers to record keystrokes. Steals login credentials. Fourth category, adware. Pop-up ads automatically on users' web pages. How can we defend against this? We need to employ anti-spyware software to detect and eliminate these threats. Now, let's discuss botnet software. What exactly is botnet software? It's a tool hackers use to hijack computers. For example, malware planted to launch DDoS attacks. This software lies dormant until activated, then strikes the intended target. To protect against botnet software, we must bolster our system security measures. Protect user devices from becoming part of a botnet. This section covers the topic of malware. That concludes our discussion on this topic.